to the August 21st, 2011 meeting of the Corrective Action Team. I think we have all of our board members here except Hope Blackman. And I think she is in session and will try to join us in a later moment. We have some guests with us this morning, members of our team, advisors. Thank you for the audits for being here. We're going to move through this rather quickly. We're going to make sure that this, we're out here at 1 o'clock because I think a lot of people do have some other meetings they have to attend and be back to. I do want to start this off, though, with making an announcement this morning. Our county council met a moment ago and got something I want to announce. We have come to an agreement, and we have a new interim administrator that's going to be with us for the next 4 months, Mr. Nelson J. Marchelli. And David, if you would, I'm going to give you just a second to tell a little bit about that.
Mr. Marchelli is former CEO of Denny's Corporation, and comes with outstanding credentials. He's been a turnaround expert for a long time. Been in business for probably approaching 39 years, and he's been in the community for a number of years here. In fact, he's been very involved in the community doing a lot of things, even like at Park Hill School. Some of you may have read some of his work there, with the tutoring and mentoring program. I think Harold Journal did a story on it a while back. But Chairman Horton, came up with this idea last week and presented to council this morning, and we unanimously agreed and jumped on board, and Mr. Marchelli was here, made a presentation to us, and we talked about this committee, in fact, in large part in our discussion with him about some of the challenges and opportunities that we have, because we really do have opportunities. You know, what's happened in the past is done and gone. We're moving forward, with the whole county, county government, and all the things that we touch. And he will be able to, I think he'll be involved with our committee. Like I say, we talked about our trip Friday, to Greenville and Cherokee County, and he's technology driven, he's results driven, high energy, very positive, again, looking for opportunities to change and to make this county a better place. He is also working for free. He's looking at this as an opportunity to give back to Spartanburg. He's got a lot of friends here. And we could not afford to pay him what he's worth if we had to. But we cannot afford this opportunity to have him come in. And so, this committee is in great shape. And we have a great opportunity working with Nelson. Over these next few months, he's committed to 4 months. We made a commitment to him. And so we'll all be a part, every one of you, in working with him to help us move quickly ahead. So, to me, this is a burst of energy and adrenaline to this CAT team. To have someone who, again, has vision and also action-oriented. So, I think it's just great news.
Yeah, this is somebody I feel we can talk to almost immediately for some of the suggestions that we come up with of what needs to be done, changes that need to be made, and he's said he's committed to getting those things done.
Said he wanted 4 or 5 action items that we wanted to work on as a council and as a committee too. 4 or 5 things that we could really go after, not 27, a list of all this stuff. 4 or 5 things that can make a big impact for the people of Spartanburg County, the citizens, the stockholders, as well as our team. And he starts tomorrow. Roger even invited him to come to this meeting today. Unfortunately, he had a lunch meeting he had to go to, but you'll see him here probably starting tomorrow. And you may see him in any department. You may see him on a truck, public works truck. He said that's the way he really has to get into it. So it's just an exciting time.
Thank you, David. We've had a couple of very exciting what I might call field trips. We had an opportunity a couple weeks ago to go over to Cherokee County and spend some time to see how their operation runs. And we also, this past Friday, I think all the team was there pretty much. We were over at Greenville to talk with those people. And for the audience, the reason that we have chosen to go to Cherokee County and to Greenville County is that we have heard word from a group of paralegals and some attorneys that said they like the way Greenville and Cherokee County does business. And guys, you know, it's a wonderful thing in this world that we don't have to reinvent the wheel, but we can take and look at other people's wheels and see that if we might want to, you know, learn from them and you know, have a, how we're going to maybe affect some change here. And I guess one of the biggest things that touched me in both of these meetings was their IT. And so I've asked Jonna to come and give us about a 10-minute presentation on what our IT specialist saw while they were there.
I don't want to bore you.
Okay, I'm gonna get out of the way.
This will be very quick.
Somebody hit the lights, please.
She may need a little bit more.
She might have to read more of that.
Thank you.
I thought those young eyes could see you.
Cat eyes.
I'm not quite that yet. Okay, so I want to say thank you for inviting us along to visit Greenville and Cherokee County. I'm currently working on a project that was assigned to me by administration that is allowing me to analyze the processes and data within Spartanburg County's assessment and permitting departments. And having done this, I had the opportunity to work with our Register of Deeds. So it kind of gave me the opportunity to look at all the three different offices, look at the, you know, differences and the similarities, and just get a whole vision of the whole picture, which was really an opportunity that I wouldn't have had otherwise. So as you can see, the document intake per month from the different Register of Deeds office, it is drastic between Cherokee County and Greenville, but between Spartanburg County and Greenville County per month is really not that considerably different, considering we have about approximately 140,000 roughly population difference. So the influx of documents actually does affect you know, how the processes work and the key functions that it needs to work. So the one thing we did notice that Cherokee and Greenville County had were commonalities were three things. They had technology and support, a streamlined workflow, and communication. And I wanted to touch on these a little bit. In their technology and support, both of their offices are either using a document management system or an enterprise resource planning system known as an ERP. They're using this technology to help them create a faster work environment, a faster and more efficient work environment for their employees. It's also much easier to use by the public, and it gives you more options for the public use of it or access to it. They also have support for their technology from administration and four other departments, meaning that their administration is supportive of their technology growth, and providing by this, they're able to provide support for other departments with their document and data imaging. It's not just a resource that's used directly within ROD. It's expanded throughout their counties. And then also, they are very technology-oriented. They mentioned that they are working with the trending technology to find solutions to current problems, and they're also looking forward to try to be proactive, and they're using technology to help leverage their costs while providing more customer service to the public. So on the second key that we have is their streamlined workflow, which comes from some of the technology. This is basically meaning that their employees are able to work their documents in a very streamlined and effective way. I mean, they can manage their working efforts. By being able to analyze how they work, their processes, they can continue to change as their needs change, which is really important because nothing stays the same. And they're using a software for automating their processes and workflow, which is also provides the means by which you can analyze your processes to see where maybe bottlenecks may occur. Their environment is conducive to their tasks. For example, their customer service is set up for quick and efficient service. However, their indexing and verification areas are set up for a distraction-free work environment. This makes, you know, the work for the employees much easier and more streamlined. And then finally, we have their communication, which I think is my professional opinion is that this is key. Their administration is very active in facilitating communication, not only within the departments and internally, but also externally to the public. They hold prep meetings to discuss successes and solutions to shortcomings, which are open to the public, the attorneys, the paralegals, and other offices of the Register of Deeds. And I believe Greenville County said that our Register of Deeds came to their first meeting and that it was very productive. So. They also their communication and interaction between departments is very fluid and constant. That provides them an easy way to find quick answers or realize problems quickly and find the answers for them that may not be so obvious just within the department. And their IT interaction for proactive solutions is really important because they're not waiting for an issue to become an issue. They're trying to look forward and see what the problems may happen and try to make make solutions for those. And then finally, it seems as from what we've heard from both the counties, between Greenville and Cherokee, that all their team members, all their departments, they have a unified goal of creating customer service and their technology use. And I think that makes a big difference when you can work together within the department internally and then between the departments. So that being said, Spartanburg County has a couple of initiatives on the table right now that I think is kind of leading us in this direction. And not that we're not there already, but there's always areas for improvement. And one is the project that we're working on right now, allowing us to improve efficiencies between and communications between departments and our software systems, letting us look at our software and how the processes in and between departments work, allowing us to see, hey, you know, there's might be a place where we can improve. And then also, we do have a bid currently out for a document management system, which in itself will help streamline many of our processes, not only in the ROD office, but countywide. And also it'll help the communication between departments, allowing document routing and workflow routing and analysis, which can simplify a lot of jobs for people, which might help in time saving and quicker turnaround. So with that being said, those
were the three. Just to be clear, that particular bid is part of the CIP. Mm-hmm. So it's funded in the CIP and not as part of the general fund.
Right. What does the 1012 mean?
That's the bid number.
Okay.
I got online. So that is basically the conclusion of what we as an IT were able to look at and see regarding processes and their overall workflow. And the technology wasn't able to really go into deeply because we can see what they're using. Their ERP system, their document management system, it's used in different forms at different places, but overall it looks like that's basically what they're using, so not able to do a apples-to-apples comparison.
So. Okay. I'm going to entertain anybody that might have some questions for John. And one thing I'd like for you to do or for someone to do before we leave here today, I'd personally like to have a copy of your PowerPoint.
Absolutely.
You know, in word form, and compute that. Is there anybody on the panel that would like to pose some questions to John?
What's keeping us from having a system similar to what we saw in Greenville? I mean, in the Register of Deeds office. You know, when those folks walked in and they were, you know, managing those, you know, requests or processes so fast, and